That's my mother. 70 years ago. And that was a picture. It was taken by one of the young men who was very fond of her and who would have to wait many years before he got to marry her. There he is, about the same time. Yep. And over there is another picture that he made of her. Yeah. And I put them on the piano, and usually I cover them with paper because the sun shines in, but right now I'm thinking it's time to reveal the world. And so, on this Sunday in August, I salute you, my friends. It's about 6:30. Wait a minute, let's see, I can tell you exactly what time it is. Oh, 6:30. That was a good guess. But I'm also interested in knowing. Hey, Google, what time does the sun set?
The sun will set at 7:38 p.m.
Hey, Google, just for the hell of it, what time is it? Too complicated. Hey, what time is it?
The time is 6:31 p.m.
Thank you, Google.
You're welcome.
Now, so the sun won't set for about an hour, but we're here in this beautiful time of summer, the dog days of August, not autumn, August, the dog days of August, and it's already Sunday, the 11th, 8, 9, 10, 11, yeah, the 11th, because Thursday was the 1st, so Thursday was the 8th, Friday was the 9th. Yesterday, Saturday, was the 10th. And today has been the 11th. Unless I'm wrong, let's see what the machine says. Hey, Google, what is the date today?
It is Sunday, the 11th of August, 2019.
Thank you, Google.
You're welcome.
Yeah, it's Sunday, the 11th of August, 2019. And I haven't done hardly any every day. I haven't done hardly any every day in August. Vlog every day in August. Thank you. Sometimes I'm happy to be playing the piano, but usually I understand my own personal failure because I don't like to do the work. There are only a few things I like to do the long, hard work for. One of those being putting words on a page and making it be like this. This is such a cliche, this poem, but I like it anyway, and it's a good example of my pith helmet and the poetic bullshit that just naturally comes out of me. I call this poem Titanic Death Archetype. Ships listed in disastrous night, and on the dark luxury roster, I saw my sinking liner going down before an iceberg of nostalgic power. Strangely enough, some prophet had already swept the decks, and so as the waters lapped nearer, my kneeling pants were scarcely soiled. Oh God, I cried. Torpedoes died. The world turned and I heard its whispered fantasque. All this must pass. I saw nothing yet what I wrote. Now that's the version of the poem as it's recorded on my brain, because within the last 5 or 10 years, I think it was here living with my mom, I worked it out how I wanted to remember that poem. And then just recently, in the last month or last 2 months, I found a manuscript that I sent to Yale Series of Younger Poets when I was 39. I applied for that program the last year that it was possible for me to send in a manuscript to be the Yale Younger Poet. I thought, well, I can't let this opportunity pass by. So I made a manuscript, and we found it as we were cleaning out the room that just getting the manuscript. Now, if I had planned this ahead of time, I would have had the manuscript right with me here at the piano. But I didn't plan it ahead of time. I'm just ordering the pizza. I don't even know what pizza I want, but I'm ordering the pizza. And let's see. I think this poem was in here. There it is, Titanic poem archetype. I called it in my memory, I called it Titanic Death Archetype. And here it is on the page, Titanic poem archetype. Ships written in disastrous night, listed on the dark luxury roster. I saw my sinking liner going down before an iceberg of nostalgic power. Excuse me, I have to burp. Now that was not part of the poem, but it probably was more poetic than this poem is, because it was accompanied by a performance of Well, since I've already broken the pattern, I can say that the first difference I noticed is In my memory, it's ships listed in disastrous night, and on the dark luxury roster I saw my sinking light. But here it says ships written in disastrous night, listed on the dark luxury roster. I can see why I dropped the word written, because it's redundant. And listed is, the double meaning comes in, ships listed. Anyhow, strangely enough, some prophet swept the decks, and as the waters lapped nearer, my kneeling pants were hardly soiled. Now the brain recorded version, I believe I recited for you, said, strangely enough, some prophet had already swept the decks, and as the waters lapped nearer, my kneeling pants were scarcely soiled. But here it says hardly soiled. Now you can see this going back and forth between one word or another across the years, because this one, this text is from 1989, when I was, or it might have been 1990, because I wasn't 40 until October of 1990. So 89 or 90, this is the version I put forward. And here is a big difference, because in my memory it's, oh God, I prayed, torpedoes died. But it says here, A, God, I prayed, torpedoes died. And then there's a period. Now this text has periods, but it doesn't have any capital letters except on the word God. Let me go through that to make sure. Yeah, that's what, at that time, when I was 39, 30 years ago, and I put together this manuscript to send off to a contest. No, someone else was chosen, not me. I was still very much into absolutely no capital letters ever, unless the word itself requires it. In the past 30 years, I've backed up a little bit to where if I'm going to construct a poem with grammar, that is, with commas and periods and those signs that tell you how the sense flows through the sentence, then I will capitalize the first word of the sentence. However, I do not, as a rule, capitalize the first word of every line. In fact, well, this poem, there's no capitalization at all except for the word God. The world turned and I heard its whispered fantask. All this must pass. I think that's almost exactly equal to my memory version. Yes, and then it's different here, because there's more here. In the version I remembered, all this must pass. I saw nothing yet what I wrote. But here it says, someone me tried to give it vision, and I saw nothing yet what I wrote. So somewhere across 30 years of thought and reflection on this poem, because this has always been one that's stuck in my mind, that Titanic one, because at the time I was breaking, at the time I first wrote it, it was 15 years before I made this manuscript. I was 25 when I wrote it, and it was right at the breakup of a big love affair, which eventually only half of it broke up, and I ended being with one of the people in the triangle, and she had a baby son 4 years later. 5 years later. And we're all going to be at the wedding, all three of us from the triangle. Because after she left me, she went back to him. Thank God, he's the only person who deserves her. And I mean that in the best sense of the word, of desert. I'm going to read you another poem here. As the sun, you can see, is sinking down into the clouds of the west. This one I called 30 years ago. I called it Remembering the Coast. Media-dressed buffoon overdosed his offbeat television sprinkles like a curse, too much rain from weatherman's sleep. Earthquake double meanings cop themselves out. They only mean who I may read them. Look, sometime, I said, and look, other said. I was thinking of living in that city and what this long to task might mean. Those lanes of houses dreaming 5 a.m., their turning pages. No, that's wrong. Those lanes of houses dreaming 5 a.m., their turning ramps of traffic frozen in a ruptured baroque above city view, Angeles Mountain behind valley sprawl. Love turning away his highway lust, that man long for sheer hiking joy. Climbing mountain ridges, foot goes over town spilled, walking up slope, earth, stone, brush, catch his breath. Open hands cover valleys and plain. He's asleep selves, then look, city mean AM Zen views sprawl. Lust joy goes slope, breath plain. I think I was different then than I am now. But I can see some in the structure. You see some of the structure here. Let me show it to you. Oh, you can't see because of there. Get the sunlight on it. See how the lines are straight on both the left and the right end of the lines? That's the one thing I still like. I try to make my poems say a little more now, instead of just being explosions of words. But I still have, and I do capitalize the first word of every sentence, usually. But now this one is more understandable. It's sort of an honor. Homage. An homage to a young woman who is no longer with us. And at the time I wrote this, was no longer with us. She was very important to I and a number of other people in the group that we all hung out together in our early 20s, late teens and early 20s. The trail to Misha. She flew off these cliffs, her wings not canvas shoes, her arms held by steel pins, where she had fallen once, onto sand and rocks below. Misha, Icarus, feathers did not meet melting wax until a truck turned left into the face of her motorcycle. Before then she flew off the cliffs where my dust is rising. Her hands become my pen, her thoughts my wings, even though I never glided, never hung like a trapezoid tarot card in the sky. She did, above the dust, Misha, gone. Inhabits green corners in the hearts left behind her. They still fly there where she went. I think of her from my dust on the cliff. Every footstep raises it on the dry trails of autumn. While traffic still rolls over the distant corner she has struck, they are flying their wings above her tall cliff beneath the sky. The hanged men and women leave every ground behind, trusting all to the wind that blows against the cliff, crying out, passing to the north, or passing to the south. I think of her at the spot where others wait to jump. Their cables rattle, wings restless in breezy hope. From my bench on top cliff looking out to sea, I think of our Icarus, cloud of dust. Under squares and triangles of flying color, I sit with only the faintest puffs of dust rising from my shoes, my feet moving a bare inch when her thought crosses my mind. The shadow moves on the sky. A wing flies by. I remember our Icarus, who lived from a trailer in Michael's backyard. Knowing how to fly with her hands, that evening she loosed the tension from Mike's sore back. After his day spent spreading concrete floors in another new wave of megalopolis. The same old bums hanging out at home. And Icarus, who laid her hands on his back, and he was moved to rest. Ah, Misha, Mikhail, too, knows those hands blown away like dust. Well, that's enough, my old poems. This poor little video log is already wasted with me. Speaking of things we find in this house as we go on our endless journey, this is a piece of stone from the high school that my mother and my stepfather and my son went there too before he dropped out to get his GED and go right into community college. God, that's aggravating. No wonder I hated music. It's the sheer dictatorial power of it. Now, I did perform in a few musical comedies and in a few plays, and I have had to surrender and submit to the power of a director who must command and control to create a unified work of art. And that's the closest I ever got personally to fascism in my life. The arts. The noises that can be bent out of an otherwise perfectly good flute. Oh my God, you stupid Daniel, you didn't watch what you were doing, and now you've spilled liquid onto the great instrument. Jeez. Louise, that's terrible. All right, first, yeah, it's coming down there, all down there. Okay, now, how bad is it? How far bad is it, he says, putting it aside, wondering what is worse. There's a piece of ice. I'm going to be really gross now and eat this piece of ice. Because I'm pissed that I spilled my drink right on the piano. Now, fortunately, doesn't appear that the water got down into the metal, but it came awful close, and I'm gonna have to move these things out of the way. I suppose all you probably saw was my big fat back cleaning up here. You didn't see the actual important stuff going on, which is right here. Look at this. Oh man, that's wet. The coaster I had sitting on top of some mail, paper envelopes, and cards that absorb most of the water. Look at this. See that? See how wet it is? All the water that could have poured down into the piano was sucked up by this paper. And I'm happy to say, the mail saved the day. Now, looking for anywhere wet around in here, feeling around, I think I got all the spilt. Oh no, there's more over here. Get a dry part of the napkin. Oh man. That's terrible. Go to the laundry. Go to the laundry, you silly laundry. Now that's not wet. And that is bone dry. So we'll try again. The only fool you know who spills his drink with a flute. Gosh almighty. Golly gee, Sergeant Carter. That's enough to make me just quit the vlog and say the hell with it. But there's something about this piano. Chair creak, 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 creak. Well, let's see if we... Now, you can see that's what the sunset looks like when it comes into this house. And, but it's not sunset yet. It's just slow. See how that chair over there? Yeah. And then, of course, outside the front, the hillside and the yard and everything is all lit up. Because it's, the sun comes through and shines into everything over there. And it comes into this room, kind of bright. And, shines on the books and the records and the things that are over there in the corner. And, go back up. Yeah. And on the picture there, there's a little house, you know, a little Christmas house we found. And then I found that picture too. Oh, come on. This is really klutzy. Bad control of the camera. Really terrible. I'm embarrassed. I'd cut this, but this is supposed to be a vlog. No cutting. No cutting allowed. Low, low, low. Am I still recording? There he is. A little boy is getting married next month. Not next month. In 3 months he's getting married. Yep. There he is. When he was 3 years old, I used to worry the hell somebody would take him away from me. And now he's all grown up, and I'm just worried about he's being a big grown-up. Yeah. That's the way life is, ain't it? They grow up, and you still worry about them. Oh, look at that big old fat dude. Who is that? Yeah, that's you-know-who. Your host to my video log. What a mess this work is. I'm jumping the camera all around every which way, and the sun's too bright and everything. But, hell, that's how it is. And that's a corner where I see that box piled up over there. Right over there. Yeah, that box right there. I've got boxes everywhere. And very slowly organizing the pictures into little boxes and putting them into those big boxes. Putting the little boxes into the big boxes. You know, I'm still really upset that I spilled water on the piano. That's a very bad thing. I mean, water's dangerous. It can stain the wood, rust the metal. Bad idea. Now, it's still about 45 minutes to sunset, and I can see lots of clouds over there. It's about to go into the clouds. So I will say goodbye to you here, and I wish you all well. on today, Sunday, the 11th of August, 2019.